Hey guys, and welcome to this tutorial. In this video I will show you how to implement your own custom landscape in Stellarium. We are going to start by taking images around the location of our telescope. Make sure that the images overlap each other quite a bit. You do not need to take pictures of the sky, as we will remove it later anyways. You can, however, take pictures of the ground around or below you. Just make sure that the edge from the horizon to the sky is visible in every direction. After taking all the images, we open the software Hugin. I put a link to that in the description. Basically, all the software does for us is put our images together into one panorama, with the advantage that we can also take images of the ground below us, and this will also be shown in Stellarium, and it just looks very nice. So now we load all our images into Hugin by clicking on Load Images and selecting the images we want to load. Now it looks kinda strange, but we can fix that by hitting the Align button. That may take a while depending on how many images you took and how good your PC is. So I actually ran into some problems right here, because I didn't get a 360 degree panorama, but only a 180 degree. So I fixed that by entering the correct value for the focal length of the camera, which was previously wrong. After letting the software align the pictures once more, they fitted very well. If you want your pictures to align even better, you can set control points. To set the control points, you click on Preview, then on Identify, and then you click on two pictures that overlap each other. Then you select two matching points in the images and click on Add, and you've got a new control point. However, the whole panorama was still shaped like a wave, so I went over to Move and Drag and hit Straighten, and now I've got a panorama with a straight horizon. We are now finished with our panorama, so I hit Create Panorama, change the output file to PNG, and I'll just leave all the other settings on default. Hit OK, name the file Field, and press Save. If you do not want to work with Hugin, or you are getting no good results, you can also use a simple panorama. After that step, we can now open our image in GIMP. We now have to remove the sky from our panorama. For that, GIMP offers different tools. You can either select the eraser and go along the edge, or you use the tool Free Select. Both of these methods work fine, and I personally use the Free Select tool. So I'm going to select all of the sky now, and I'll be right back. Now I just need to connect the start and the end, and I can now hit Delete and the sky is gone. It is completely up to you how precise you want to do this. We now have to create a new image. The size of the image has to be in the 16:9 format, and I choose the 8K resolution, so it is 7680 to 4320 pixel. In the advanced options, we select Fill with Transparency. This is very important, because otherwise the sky won't be transparent in Stellarium. We can then hit OK and take the image where we just deleted the sky and drag it over to our new image. We now position the image in the middle of the screen, and we now need to fill up all the space that is left under the image with some kind of color. I used a dark green, because that's roughly the color of the field. If I had taken more images of the ground below and around me, I wouldn't have needed to fill up that much space with a simple green. We can now export the file, and it is very important that the checkbox Save background color is not ticked, because if it is, the sky won't be transparent. I created a folder in Documents, which I named Stellarium, and in there I have my custom landscapes. So in there I created a new folder named Field, and I will put the image in there. Now we have to create a .ini file. The text you need for that file is in the description. You can simply copy it from there. To create the .ini file, we need to create a new text document, which we name Landscape. We now open the text document and put in the copied text. Now we hit Save As, and say all files and write landscape.ini and then we can save. Now we have created the .ini file. We can now delete the text document. In the .ini file, you now have to set the name you want your landscape to be shown with in Stellarium and the description, which is also shown in Stellarium. Next to the map text, you have to write the exact name of the panorama file. You also have to enter your coordinates and your altitude. For now, we can ignore the last point, angle rotation. The next step is to put the folder we just created into a zip file. We can now start Stellarium, go into the menu point, sky and viewing options, select landscape and click on add/remove landscapes. Then a little window pops up and we click on install a new landscape from a zip archive. Now we select the folder we have just put into a zip archive and confirm by clicking on open. Stellarium is now loading our landscape. Most likely the horizon of the simulation you see in Stellarium won't match the horizon in real life. Moreover, the positions of north, south, west and east are likely wrong. We can adjust the height of the horizon by moving the image up or down in GIMP. The compass directions can be adjusted by entering a value in the .ini file at the point angle rotation. You simply have to experiment with the height of the panorama and the angle rotation until it matches the real life. So there you have it, your own custom landscape in Stellarium. It helps me out a lot as I can plan ahead because I now know to which time I see which objects. I hope this tutorial helped you out and everything worked fine. If you still have any questions, feel free to ask them in the comments and I will try to help you out. Clear skies.